Now we see the second lesson. In my first lesson, just you see the introduction function. Then the same view. Now we start the second lesson. Okay. Before this, you know the higher secondary second year software details. For computer science students, this year we learned Python, WAMP Server 86 for MySQL. Especially for computer application students, just so you know, your friend may be in 21, just to say, they learned PageMaker 7.0, Notepad Plus, PHP is the especially for computer application software. Now you learn the on 5th chapter onwards Python and a WAMP server. Okay. This chapter we see data abstraction. Data abstraction is a powerful concept in computer science that allows programmer to treat code of object. What is code of object? You learn in first year Dave C++ programming. This is the code. Programming code is simply called as code of object. This year we learn Python as the code of object. For example, we properly learn Python coding on 5th chapter onwards. Here in this lesson, the core object can be, example should be given. Before this general instruction I given to you, follow the my first lesson video. Properly, student laptop issued by the school can be used for this purpose. You have laptop in your home, it should be used. Before you see the YouTube link, read the lessons thoroughly. First, suppose if you learn second chapter, just go through the data abstraction lesson and then take notes. If you have any doubt, type text messages to your WhatsApp group number. Before this, I go to the lesson just to show you the car driving video. You see, the car driving video. Based upon this video, I say something about this lesson. For this motivation, I give the car video. Okay. Now, you go through the lesson. You see the car driving video. The car driving video show the how the car can be moving. Here, the car is the object. In this car, you know the accelerator image and then speed image. So, in this video, just you learn how the car can be moved. Okay, the next topic we deal with project. Project refers to the programming. Programming means what? High level programming language can be used as, here we say programming language. First year you learn Dave C++, the high level language programming. This year you learn Python. Then abstraction. Abstraction provides modularity. Modularity means splitting a program into the many models. Suppose you see the video car video, just you know the accelerator only. What are the inner parts of the car? We don't know. The car driver does not know. But it should be the abstraction. Abstraction means it should be hide. All the things can be hide. Just you learn the elements only. Then classes. The classes structure are the representation for the abstract data type ADT, simply we see as ADT. The classes can be one of the special topic in the latter issue. And then in this lesson, you learn abstract data type. Abstract data type is a type or the class for object whose behavior is defined by a set of value and the set of operation. Very simple. You learned first year some of the types. Whole number as int, fraction number as float, non-numeric character as the CHR. This is the type. So behavior defined to the set of the value. We should be defined in the variable constant like this. Then replicate. Data application replicate how we think about the world. For example, drive a car. Our motivation, my motivation is, you see how the we drive a car. This is the motivation. So here the data abstraction replicate how we think about the world. Suppose you learn car driving. You think about the car driving. It is the example to you. And then next we see the types of function. First year you learn constructor. The same constructor can be learned in the Python also. What is constructor? A constructor or function that build the abstract data type. Then next one, selectors. Selectors are function that receive information from the data type. Here we see the example in page number 12. Refer, should be elaborately given. Some example can be given in your book. Just you go through it. Then rational numbers. A rational number is a ratio of integer, and a rational number constitute an important subclass of real numbers. In rational numbers, we have the syntax like this: numerator, denominator. In my example, numerator is x 8, denominator is 3. Simply I show the example 8 slash, slash means division, 8 slash 3, your answer is 2.66 and so on. Some of the answer can be elaborately. It is the rational number. On my next lesson, in 5th lesson onwards, I show the example in the properly in Python program also. And then next topic, visual thinking. Visual thinking is the formation of brief and making decision according to what might be pleasing to imagine instead of by applying the reality. In reality, you see the car. It's a reality. Visual thinking, here the make decision. How many speed? You go to the car. This is the decision. So according to what might be pleasing, replacing the imagine instead of by appealing the reality. In real life, it can be applied. Here we simply say the concept visual thinking. This is the visual thinking. And then list. Very simple. What is list? List is constructed by placing expression within square bracket separated by comma. For example, you give the mark like this: 100, 93, 41, 73, 4 subject mark should be taken. You should be given in the square bracket. Here we specify the square bracket. It is called as list. We see in the latter topic, list tuple can be in a separate topic. We see elaborately. And then tuple. Tuple or tuple. What is tuple? A tuple is a comma separated by sequence of values surrounded by within parentheses. For example, in my example, tuple 1 is a variable. I say the 2, 4, 6, 8, 10 as 5 numbers. It should be in within parentheses. It means simply bracket. If you say anything in the bracket, we simply call it as tuple. What is the difference between list and tuple? List means any value in the square separated by comma in the square bracket. Square bracket, if you mention anything in the square bracket, we simply call it as list. If you mention anything in the parenthesis, it means bracket, it should be the tuple. It is the main difference between the main and the tuples. And then data abstraction. It's the last topic in this lesson, data abstraction. In structure, you learn structure in the first year. The same structure can be defined here also. A list allow data abstraction. You see list. A name to a set of memory cells. You see some of the data can be in memory cells. For example, if you play a game, mastermind game, here list of 4 plus can be motivated. Red, blue, green, yellow. Here the in the data abstraction, the four class is the memory cell. Okay. Then this lesson conclusion. A class has bundled data and the function that work on the data. Complex data is a very simple way. It means class means is a bundled data. In our example, in first year you learn data. Data contain three part. Int, float, chr, like this. It should be in a class. Here we say in Python class. Don't worry, a class has bundled data and the functions that work on the data. Here, very simple example, complex data. For example, if you deal with quadratic equation, complex data can be given. Okay. Then, now, I briefly explain the second chapter. Go through. Here the learning object of the second chapter, data abstraction, is in this lesson you understand what is abstract data structure, second one abstract data type, third one difference between the concrete and abstract implementation, then next one pair, and then last one data abstraction in structure. Okay, thank you. We see the next video, the third lesson. I once again remind you, just go through the lesson. Okay, thank you.